So the next type of parsers which we are going to study, they are LALR parser and CLR parser. So we are going to study LALR 1 and CLR 1 parser. And this LALR 1 and CLR 1 parser, both of them are going to use something called as LR 1 items. They are going to use something called as LR 1 items. And what is a LR 1 item? It is the LR 0 item. Plus, with every item, we are going to add something, some look ahead symbol or something called as a look ahead symbol. Okay, and this is also called as this. It is also called as we will use canonical collection of LR1 item. So we are going to use canonical collection of LR1 item. Okay. And you can represent it this way. See, LR1 item plus look ahead, LR1 item is LR0 item plus look ahead symbol, which will look something like this. S derives dot AA slash, if you write A slash B. Here in this case, you can see this is representing the same LR0 item. This is representing the same LR0 item, but this is representing the look ahead symbol. Look ahead symbol. I'll tell you what is a look ahead symbol and how to find a look ahead symbol. So this, and we have this comma. So there's no meaning of this comma here between both of them. Okay, so this comma is only used to separate this LR0 item and this look ahead symbol. So in this case of in this kind of parsers, we are not going to place the reduce move in the entire row or in the fall of left hand side. We are just going to place it in the look ahead symbol. So you can see we are not going to place reduce moves in the entire row or in fall of left hand side. We are just going to place the reduce move in the look ahead symbol. And I'll tell you how to find the look ahead symbol. Okay. So assuming that we have a grammar like this, S derives AA, where S derives AA slash B. Okay. Assuming that this is the particular grammar. For this particular grammar, if we take the start symbol, now first of all we have to make it a augmented grammar. So we have to make S dash derive S, S derives AA, and A derives AA slash B. Now if I want to find LR1 item, now this LR1 item can be found like this. This is the start symbol. The look ahead symbol for start symbol is always dollar, right? So this can be written as S dash derives dot S comma dollar. For start symbol, the look ahead symbol is always dollar. This will always be there. For other items, we have to find the look ahead symbol. Okay, and this is again, this is LR0 item. Okay, for initial production, you can say in LR1 item, for initial production, that is the start, the look ahead symbol is always dollar. Look ahead symbol is dollar. Okay, and here because there's a dot in the beginning of this production, therefore we have to add all the productions of S, just like we found the closure in the previous case. For example, if I want to find I naught, now I naught will look something like this: S dash derives dot S comma dollar, and because there's a dot in the beginning of a variable, so we have to add a production of this, that is S derive dot AA. Okay, and here again the look ahead symbol is dollar. Okay, and how do you find this look ahead symbol? Look ahead symbol is this is the first of dollar in S dash. Okay, so that is I'll tell you what is this first of this, so but just explain this. Here if I found A derives dot AA comma A slash B and dot B comma A slash B. Here the look ahead symbol is changing. How do we find the look ahead symbol like this? See, here because we have a dot in the beginning of this variable, that is why I have to write all the productions of this A like this. But after this A, we have a variable. So we have to write the first of this one. Whatever the first of A, that will become the look ahead symbol here. Again, in the previous case, if you check this case, in this case, after this dot, we have a S. Therefore, we have to write all the productions of S. But after this S, there is nothing here. Because there is nothing here in this case, that is why the look ahead symbol of the next next item will be exactly the same. Okay, so let me tell you, if you have any production like this, A derives alpha dot B beta. Now, and we have A slash B. Now, if you write for B, because there's a dot in the beginning of B, so we have to write all the productions of B. For example, it is B dot gamma something. But you can see after this B, we have some beta. And if this beta is a variable, or you can say if this beta is a non-terminal, then whatever the first of this beta, then whatever the first of this beta will become the look ahead symbol here, comma will become the look ahead symbol. For example, the first of this beta is C slash D, that C comma D, that is C and D becomes the look ahead symbol here. Okay, but if we don't have any beta here, but if we don't have any beta, for example, we have the production like this, A drives alpha dot B and B drives dot gamma. Now after this B, there is no variable here, because there is no variable here. So whatever the look ahead symbol of this production, for example, the look ahead symbol of this production is A slash B, that will also become the look ahead symbol for the next item. Okay, so this is what we use in case of LR, this LALR 1 and CLR 1 parser. That is, we are going to use LR 1 items, and this LR 1 item is a LR 0 item plus some kind of look ahead symbol. Okay, and we are not going to place the reduce move in the entire row. We are just going to place it in the look ahead symbols. So let me do one thing. Let us take some examples and let us try to see what will be the look ahead symbols for those cases. Okay, so I'll take around 3 to 4 examples. That will be enough so that you can see how do you find the look ahead symbols of the other productions. Okay, or you can say the other items.